imagine a world where there is unlimited, clean, very cheap energy, the world will look extremely different from the world we have today. Our goal at CFS is to be generating about 20% of the world's energy market by 2050 using fusion. At its very core, fusion is the type of energy that powers the stars. So we do this on Earth with magnets. And that's what we're building for our device. It's, you know, kind of, we call it a sun in a bottle, taking these giant magnets, causing these hydrogen atoms in plasma to fuse together. That produces our heat, which we then turn into electricity. I've been really motivated by solving hard problems and doing what people say can't be done. For me, I see fusion as a solvable engineering challenge. One thing that really drew me to fusion is that I had spent my life living by Sally Ride's motto of reach for the stars, and here I am building a star on Earth. I've always been driven by this idea of wanting to change the world for the better, and a lot of that love for space grew into how do we clean up this planet instead of getting off of it. I talked about Sally Ride being, you know, my childhood hero, and she didn't actually come out as queer until her obituary. If I had known that as a kid, how much better that would have been, and to know that I'm not alone and I'm not the only queer woman interested in space. I joined CFS as the 10th employee, and I was really excited by not just building this really cool technology, but building a team and broadly building a company culture where anybody feels welcomed to bring their full self to work and build cool stuff and change the world.